What you know about time? I'm talking about timelines. I'm talking about 10 seconds to shine.
I'm talking about the amount we spent on that baseline.
What you know about descendancy, aligned with time creating interdependencies, the tendency to connect through community, the BSAC and the EDI creating unity.
Two committees, is that just it?
Checking off required boxes so y'all can fit?
There's no I in team, and our history has shown
that no work gets done when we go through it alone. Playing defense in zones, sets don't get won on their own.
It takes a family to make a gym feel like a home.
Gardons la forme de nos anciennes. Apprenons leurs leçons, oublions leurs peines. Inspirons la génération qui vient. Car le respect et l'inclusion sont des choses qui s'apprennent. L'oiseau en cage se transforme en cheval, sortant sur la piste, visant la première place sur la liste.
Leaders from yesterday, today and tomorrow, black culture transcribed through time and can't be borrowed.
We create and recreate the world we all know by turning sorrows into culture and rhythm into flow.
Endless hours, running lines, study sessions, and overtimes. Off-the-court effort may feel unrecognized, but even Six God said, when all the lights go out, that's when you see the real guys.
Sur le terrain comme sur la glace, prenons notre place. Peu importe les injustices auxquelles nous faisons face, un pied après l'autre, avançons avec classe.
As time winds down, have you taken a moment to reflect? I know it's behind you, but the shirt still says respect.
I hope you know with time a change.
GGs can come together and would never be the same.
Passing down torches, igniting our flame, rewriting all the rules of our so-called life game.
We've been apart for a long time. Multiple futures lay before us. Where are we going? How will we get there? How do we make things better? We can build, but if we dream together, we can rebuild. We can create. But if we work together, we can recreate. We can connect, but only if we can find a way to reconnect. As we lead the charge towards a more inclusive society, we need your help to recharge our spirits. As we make progress towards a sustainable future, we need your help to remake the status quo. While others write off the search for a better world, you can help us lead the research that will rewrite the way forward. What happens next is up to us. Let's work together to reimagine what's possible.
Dear women, you should be defined as resilient, courageous, competitive, and confident. Thank you for earning your rightful spots and surprising those who told you that you couldn't hit that shot. For breaking molds that society has created without fear of being criticized or hated. To your winning streaks, world records, gold medals, and more, you put in that work and it reflects in more ways than just a score. You keep your head up high and continue to lead the way, becoming moms, sisters, friends, and partners to all people that encourage you to play.
Open to the backhand, go!
And finally, you're capable of all. You get up bigger and better, no matter how hard you fall. Women, don't let anything get in your way, as it's Women's Day all day and every day.
What a game of hockey!
Their first victory of the year.
Good afternoon, folks. We are here in Montpetit Hall for a tilt between the Ottawa GGs and Université de Montréal Carabin volleyball programs. Eric, we're in for a good game today. Montreal sitting second in the rankings of the RSEQ, 4-1 for the season's GGs, 2-2 in the middle of the pack. What do you expect here from this game today?
No, I'm expecting a pretty good fight from both teams here. Obviously, Montreal's got a very talented squad, but with Ottawa's recent wins in the past couple weeks, should be a great game. Right side ball there from Avery Hughes comes back over, and there's a big kill by Audrey Odigi to start us off.
Odigi, a missed presence on the GGs that last two games. Just coming back today from an ankle injury and already showing her impact on the front court.
Nicole Hildebrand back to serve for the G's. Middle attack there from Montreal is a kill back into position one. G's struggled with that last week, was defending on the middle attacks against UCAM. We'll see if they can change that here against the Carabin.
Absolutely, looking like a bit more of a reasonable sized middle rotation for the Carabin. Should be less of an issue for the GGs, but we'll see as this game goes on.
Bit of a scramble play there at the net as the ball falls on the side of the G's. Nice dump attack there by number two from Montréal, Chloe Gallarneau-Haley. Good pass there by the G's. Slide attack from McKay is called in by the Lions person. Point GG's. Boy, that ball sure was close in the back line there, but great attack from McKay.
No, great start for the middles here for the GG's. We had some issues clicking last game, but good to see them get the runs right at the start of this first set.
Carabin go for the middle. A little bit of a miscommunication error there. Middle tipped it just wide. That will be point G's as they take a 3-2 lead here early in the first set. Setter Maxime Langevin back to serve for the GG's. Overpass there and a huge kill from Avery Hughes. Montreal just could not get around on the block there and a big kill from Hughes.
Now great discipline by Hughes. Waiting for that ball to come just over the net before sending it back to receiver.
A couple big party ball kills already for the G's. Pipe attack here from Montreal. Good dig by Langevin. Right side from Hughes. Another ball falls tight. And after a bit of a scramble, chaotic play there at the net, ball does fall on the side of the Carabin. That will be point GG's once again. Nice run here to start the first set.
Absolutely. We're seeing a great opening first few points by the GGs. Well composed, not messing around when the ball is coming back on their side of the court.
Yeah, good to see them being very aggressive, but not overly eager to put those balls down right away. It can be easy to get called on those. Good tip there from Hughes. Left side attack from the Carabin. Good pickup by Odigi. Langevin forced to give a free ball over. Left side attack and a great dig by Bristow. Langevin gives another free ball over off some great defense by the GGs. Middle attack and it goes out. Some great defense by Ottawa there. Hard earned point.
Yep, that's what you like to see. Especially when you're forced to give a few free balls to the other team. GGs not backing down on the defensive end at all.
Langevin on serve once again. Tight ball, and it falls. Great serve by Langevin. Carabin just could not control it there, and it does fall on their side of the net.
Love the pressure the GGs are putting on right here in this first set. No errors on their end so far.
Right side attack from the Carabin. And a kill there off the hands of Langevin and into the roof. Great kill there by number 14, Alain Desmet. Good to see the G's getting out to an early start. They struggled with that in some of the sets last week against UCAM, getting down 4 or 5 points early on and then struggling to come back. But great start here as they open up a 7-3 lead. tight pass to the net. G's get a free ball back over on the dump. Left side attack from Hughes. Good pickup by Langevin. Free ball over for Bristow. Left side attack from Montreal. Good block, but recycled. Middle attack there, and it will ultimately fall. Great middle play there by Montreal as they get the middle kill.
Yeah, some good blocks from the GG still. Getting two up on that middle in transition. Just gets the ball squeaked through from the Carabin middle.
Left side attack from Hughes once again. Touched at the net off the block, and it goes long, so it will be point G's. ODG back to serve now.
GG's with a plethora of wing options here, knowing that all three hitters on the court can put that ball away. Just the luxury of this program right now.
Yeah, ODG was a big presence miss for the GG's last week. Grace McHale did a great job filling in her absence, but as this one will fall on this, it will be point Montreal, four touches called by the umpire. Server for the Carabin is number 14, Alain Desmet. Left side attack from Bristow of the G's, tips it deep. Middle attack from Montreal. Good block by the G's. Now a right side attack from Montreal. And there's a big kill by number two, Chloe Gallardo-Ailey. A couple big right side swings from Montreal early on. Is that something you think the G's will look to shut down?
No, yeah, absolutely. It seems like it's a key run for them so far, especially when the setter is able to flip the rotation here and spread the court along the net.
Big block there by Montreal on the right side attack from Hughes. Looks like she read that perfectly, brought the block inside on noticing the set was a little bit in and stuffed it right into the attack line. Great play there by Montreal.
GG's lead closing now, only up 8-7. We'll see how they respond.
Good pass by Bristow. Right side attack from Hughes once again. This time she tips, puts Montreal in a little bit of trouble, but they do manage to run middle. Good dig by Jones, but it will fall just wide on the far side.
Gigi's getting their test now of their side-out efficiency to start the game. They were on the run with their serve, which really gave them the advantage of just playing some strong defense, but their serve receive right now is what's holding them back.
Pipe attack from ODG, and this goes into the net. Unforced error is starting to become a bit of a problem for the G's here, both on serve receive and on swinging.
Yeah, Gigi's got to really focus on giving Max Langevin a good ball that opens all three options in the front row for her. They're keeping her a bit behind the attack line there, where the Carabin opposite blockers know that it's got to go high and far somewhere.
Yeah, difficult to run the middle off that. Really lets the middle blockers cheat over to the pins. Makes it difficult to get some good swings there. As another point goes to the Carabin on a great serve, great short serve there by Desmet. And off the tape roll, that will be an ace for the Carabin. They open up a 10-8 lead. And head coach Lionel Woods of the G's looks to call timeout as his team now trails by three. Welcome back inside Montpetit. Following the timeout, it is still Alain Desmet to serve here for the Carabins. Good pass by Jones. Middle swing by McKay is tipped, but just short. A little bit of a miscommunication there. Looks like McKay thought they were running more of a push, whereas Langevin got that ball a little bit quick, closer to her body.
Yep, tough play there. Almost exactly what you want. The GGs haven't been able to run the middle the last few serving opportunities, so good tactical play, but just execution.
And there's a huge block by McKay to get the G's back on serve. Good middle run there by the Carabins, but an even better block by McKay as she now goes back to serve.
Momentum changing point for sure.
Absolutely.
GG's picking up some energy there. They're looking a little flat.
McKay back to serve here with the G's down 12-9. Looks like a C-ball attack there from the Carabins. Now a right side shot from Hughes of the G's. Good dig by the Carabins. They'll go for a pipe swing. And some miscommunication there in the back row between Ojiji and McKay. Ball falls, that will be point Carabin. Always difficult with no libero in the back row. Having to have the middles play defense in five can always cause a little bit of confusion.
Yeah, we noted that last week, Eric, where quite a few instances of the middle having to serve and play defense and causing some issues that otherwise would have been routine plays with the libero in the backcourt.
Good up by Jones on serve. Bristow with a big left side swing, but blocked in the court by the Carabin. Well blocked there by number 10, Sarah McLaughlin. Good pass there by Odigi. C-ball from Hughes. Easily dug by the Carabin. They now go to the left side. Great dig by Jones. Ball goes back onto the Carabin side. Setter turns and swings, called in by the linesman. Always difficult with a left-handed setter. You always have that option to turn and burn there.
Yep, difficult play. You don't see it coming until the last minute. That shoulder sneaking up and burying that ball in the back corner.
Grace McHale substitutes in for Danae Bristow on the left side for the G's. Coach Lionel Woods looking to get some new passing and swinging options in the front row. Carabin serve is long. That will be point G's. Hughes goes back to serve now with the GGs down 15-10. Serve by Hughes is right on the line. Excellent call there by the linesperson, who is not an official referee for today's game. However, makes the right call there, and that will be point G's. Great serve by Hughes. Right side attack, C-ball looks like, from the Carabin. Great dig by Jones. McHale on the left side, swing. Forces the Carabin out of system. And a good swing there in the back row by Desmet. Goes just over the hands of McHale in the back row and falls in the back line. Carabin now up 16-11 here in the first set.
Good transition defense and offense by the GGs there, but sometimes good defense is just beat by better offense in that case.
Served by the Carabins, number 19 goes long. That will be point G's as McHale goes back to serve now. McHale had a couple of great serving runs in the last game as she filled in for the injured Ajiji. See what she can cook up with the G's here today. Pipe attack from the Carabin, well dug, manages to avoid the ceiling. Although the free ball given over by the G's is outside the antenna, that will be point Carabin.
That's a tough play there for the GGs. You just squeak that ball up through the rafters, avoiding narrowly the basketball net, and then you just miss that third contact up and give an easy point to the Carabin.
Good pass by McHale. Left side swing from Odigi. Huge swing back into position number 5. Big kill there by Odigi. The G's desperately needed that to get back in this set.
Yep, finally the G's get a ball put down. And they can kind of rely on that option there with DG, a great swinger on the left side for the G's.
Hildebrand now back to serve for Ottawa. Her float serve, left side attack from the Carabin. Good dig by Mikhail. Hughes unable to get there on the diving play. Good kill there from the Carabin.
Desmet's been proving to be a problem for the GGs. Doesn't matter what ball she seems to get, she seems to swing at it with full force, blistering through the blocks.
Good pass there on serve receive by Hughes. And a big kill there from McKay. Interesting that they dropped Hughes back to pass on serve receive, but clearly it paid off as she could put a great ball up for Langevin, giving her all three options in the front row.
Yeah, GGs have the luxury of drawing Avery Hughes into the serve rotation, serve receive rotation, since she played left side last year for the club, allowing the front court left side to focus on attacking the first ball.
Left side attacking the Carabin. Another big block by the G's. This time it's Hughes. Amazing point there from the G's. Two big blocks. First one was recycled by the Carabin, but Hughes said no sir on the second one. Langevin now back to serve once again. Middle attack from the Carabin goes out. Montreal looking for a touch call but won't get it. That will be point GG's as the score is now 18-16 in favor of Montreal. G's have really come back in this one.
Yeah, it's been proving to be a set of runs so far. GG's going up 8-2 to start and then trailing 15-10 at one point.
Right side attack from Desmet. Ball does get blocked by ODG but ultimately falls on the G's side. Difficult play there with the right side swinger there and Desmet being as talented as she is. Good touch by ODG, just couldn't press on that ball to get it back over.
Yeah, Gigi's knowing very well that she could go rip that ball across, trying to stay patient to follow her swing, but not able to get over in time.
Great pass by ODG on serve receive. Left side ball for Hughes. Blocked by the Carabin, touched by Mikhail, but it does fall back on the Gigi's court. Point Montreal as they open up a 20-16 lead. And head coach Lionel Woods once again wants to talk things over with his team. Overpass there by the G's results in a kill from the Carabin. Difficult play there as no real option for Langevin to block that coming out of the back row.
No. And as we heard, Eric, Cardi B's I Like It Like That playing through the timeout, but can't say we like that first play from the GG's.
Short serve there by the Carabin, picked up by the G's. Mikhail forces a free ball over. They run the right side for Desmet. Big block there from Hughes. Shuts the door on Desmet there. Great point for the G's if they want to have any chance of coming back and winning this set, down 21-17.
Avery Hughes with a couple huge blocks here for the G's in this first set. Hopefully this carries some momentum for the rest.
ODG back to serve. Pipe attack from the Carabin. Good dig by ODG. McKay swings. Left side out of system ball from the Carabin is a tip. Good pickup by Langevin. McKay sits out of system to Mikhail. Right side attack from Desmet of the Caravan. Blocked once again. This time it's Grace McHale on the left side with a huge block. G's trail now just 3 points, 21-18.
That's that momentum we're looking for. Big points there for the GGs back to back. Huge blocks from the right side.
Another serve from Odigi, tight ball here. Blocked over by Hughes, and now a lift called on the Carabin as they look to dig that back up.
Oh yeah, Eric, no need to call an elevator technician here. There's clearly something wrong with that lift.
And that will be timeout Montreal as Ottawa comes back to trail by just 2 points. Odigi back to serve here for the GGs, down just 21-19 now. Great comeback here in a very tight first set. But her serve does sail just long. That will be point Carabin as they go up 22-19. G's yeah. Going to have to do some good siding out here with Desmet's serve.
Exactly. They were in the position they want to be. Their side out game hasn't been so strong this set, but their serving pressure has been. Tough break to miss the first serve coming out of that timeout.
Langevin with a long run. McHale with the left side swing. Forced out of system. Big swing from Desmet there. Picked up by the Carabin. They go left side. And a big kill there from Chloe Gallardo-Haley.
She just has quite the wind up on her swing. Full rotation of her arm there. And clearly putting enough power behind that ball, making it difficult for the GGs to react.
Yeah, Carabin running a very quick tempo on their left side balls too. Makes it difficult for the right sides or the setters to get out and block. McHale with the tip here. Now a right side attack. Picked up by the G's, they give a free ball back over. Now a setter dump, and that will score. Great play there by setter Sarah McGlashan. And that will be 24-19 in favor of Montreal as they get set point here in the first set.
Carabin doing a lot of transition work there, running their left side out on the right, not having that left side option available, confusing the G's, and setter Sarah McGlashan taking advantage just to put that ball away.
Ball called out on the line off the Carabin serve. That will be point G's. Carabin coach not happy about it, but it is 24-20. McKay back to serve now for the GGs. Good float serve there. Left side attack from the Carabin. Touched off the block. G's with a roll shot over. Great swing there by Odigi. Left side attack from the Carabin. And that will do it for the first set. Big swing by by Chloe Gallardo-Haley on the left side there. And that will be 25-20 in favor of Montreal. Welcome back inside Montpetit Hall for set number two between the Montreal Carabins and the U Ottawa Gigis in some RSEC women's volleyball action. Montreal took the first set by a score of 25-20. Gigis will look to turn that around here in the first set as there's a big kill from Audrey Odigi to get us started. She's got a couple great kills already. Big swings for the Gigis here, bringing a lot of energy for the team.
Yep, hopefully they can start off this set like they did the first here and get a big lead going and then hopefully carry that momentum throughout the whole set this time.
Yeah, absolutely. I think it comes down to limiting runs for the Gs. They had a couple, Carabins had a couple of really big runs there, especially with Desmet in the back row serving their number 14. And I think if the Gs can cut down on some of those runs, they'll be in a better position to win this set.
Yeah, the first set there, they proved that their serving pressure was pretty key for them. Being able to get control of the ball and stay with it has been crucial so far in this set for both teams.
Left side attack from Odigi, and there's another kill from the rookie. Off the block and out. Another great kill there from Audrey Odigi. Very impressive considering she's only about 2 weeks out from a sprained ankle.
Yeah, that doesn't show any signs of injury so far in this game. Always a high flyer on the team and definitely a thunderous hitter option.
Hildebrand on serve for the Gs. Left side attack now from the Carabins. And a big kill there off the hands of Hildebrand and out. Looks like Desmet, the right side, came in and hit a back row left side ball. Montreal playing out some trickery here in the second set.
Absolutely. I think they know that she's their go-to hitter there and trying to get her in as many rotations as they can.
Setter Sarah McLaughlin back to serve for the Carabins. Great pass there by Mikhail and a bullet of a serve. Odigi's ball is blocked back onto her side, picked up by Mikhail, and that will fall on the side of the Carabins. No one called for the ball, no one took it, and that will be point Ottawa.
Yeah, quick reaction there by Grace Mikhail, getting nice and tight in on the coverage on Odigi's swing and just putting that ball where it could be played.
Langevin now, the server for the Gs. Tough float serve puts the Carabins in some trouble. They will be forced to give a free ball back over. Mikhail to Langevin. Goes to the middle for McKay. That ball flies just out the back. Looks like the set was a little bit low there from Najvain, and McKay had to kind of punch that ball deep.
Yeah, McKay just trying to fix the ball, put it in play. It was a great idea to just pop it as high and deep as she could, just going a few inches out that back line.
Pass up here for Mikhail. Langevin goes right side for Odigi. Now we point Carabins. They'll say the ball did not get over the net. Now we'll give Montreal a 4-3 lead here in the second set.
Gigi's relying a lot on Odigi to start the second set. Been efficient so far. We'll see how they keep distributing the ball.
And that serve flies long from the Carabins. That will be point Gigi's as Odigi goes back to serve now at a tie game 4-4. So far, it's looking like the team that passes better on serve receive will be the team that wins the game. Been difficult to steal points here. There's one, though, from the Gigi's. Big swing by Avery Hughes on the overpass. Another party ball kill from the Gigi's. Yeah. They've been feasting on those all afternoon.
That's the second for Avery Hughes today so far early in this game. Rare to see that happen twice in a game, let alone this early.
Big serve there from Odigi, but a great pass by the Carabins. Good back quick attack there. More trickery from the Carabins as they will get a kill in the back row.
Now Carabins doing a great job distributing the ball when they're in system. Pulling out all tips and tricks here against the Gs, which haven't been able to figure out their system yet.
Kaiser Tourigny back to serve for the Carabins. Tight pass by Mikhail Langevin. Manages to fix it, but the swing from McKay goes just long. Bit of a tight pass there for Mikhail. Puts Langevin in a little bit of trouble, but still a valiant effort there from the Gs.
Yep, Max Langevin still able to go up nice and high and just get a touch on that ball and try and give McKay an instance where she could put that ball away, just hitting that one a little deep again.
Pipe attack from Odigi. Goes into the net, point Carabins as they open up a 7-5 lead here.
Yeah, a few sloppy runs here by the Gs. Gotta do better when knowing the ball's not in the perfect situation to give it your best swing and just put the ball over and in play.
Yeah, absolutely. It comes down to patience. It's been difficult. It's been difficult to be patient against a team like the Carabins who have really good blocking abilities. And if you give them a free ball, they're a good chance of scoring. But you just got to be patient and make the smart shots.
Yeah, absolutely.
Good kill there from the Carabin off the hands of the left side and out. That'll give him an 8-5 lead as Kaiser Tourigny goes back to serve once again. This is a situation the G's found themselves early in the first set. If they can get out of this run quickly, that'll be to their benefit. Swing from McKay. Manages to fall eventually. Some great hustle there from the Carabin, but that will be point GG's. Hopefully this is the point that they needed to get some momentum back in the second set.
Yeah, they've been running middle quite a bit here so far in the second set. Good to see them finally connect and score a point off it as McKay goes back to serve.
Yeah, absolutely. Hopefully that gives Langevin some confidence to keep running her as well. She's gone to her early and often in this set, both her and ODG, so good to see it paying off now for the G's. Right side attack from Desmet of the Carabin. Sails long. She was looking for hands on the block there, but will not find any. Point G's as they cut the Carabin lead down to just 1 point.
Yeah, good discipline block there by the GG's. They knew they were well set to cover their ground on their side of the court and not pressing into that ball direction to get a touch.
Deep serve here from McKay. Left side attack from the Carabin is a huge swing from Gallardo Haley. Difficult block there for the G's, knowing that Gallardo Haley has gone cross court on so many of these early swings. Yeah. Really mixed it up on them there, pounded that ball down the line.
She saw nice and early that that block was taking her cross, and she said, you know what, it's time I go line, and great swing on her part.
Great fix there from Langevin of the G's. Now a left side swing from Gallardo Haley. She'll tip it right into the pot. Great shot there from the left side. No one covering there for the GG's, unfortunately. Difficult play there trying to put up a double block.
Yeah, Gallardo Haley definitely playing with the minds of the GG's defenders here, as we just said, bouncing a few cross, then going line, and then now tipping that one over the block.
Another tight pass from the G's. Middle swing there from the Carabin. Right side swing now from Hughes of the G's, and a huge block by the Carabin, but it does fall out of the court. That will be point Ottawa. G's got to focus on the passing a little bit here, especially with Langevin. When Langevin was in the back row, she was struggling with a lot of those tight balls because, of course, she can't put that over on second contact from the front row.
Yeah, definitely seems that that was a talking point in between sets here. As last set, the G's were really pushing those passes away from the net, even when Langevin was in the front row, and now it seems they've made the adjustment to try and push it a little tighter and making the opposite error and overcompensation here, but they'll find the middle ground soon, hopefully.
Yeah, absolutely. And now that Langevin finds herself in the front row there in position number four, hopefully even on some of those tighter balls, she'll be able to turn and burn, maybe get a dump in there for the G's.
Yeah.
Pass off the net there from ODG. Left side attack from Mikhail. Looking for that corner. Goes really cross court, but it does sail just wide. That will be point Carabin as they now lead 12-8 with Gallardo Haley back to serve.
Yeah, impressive swing still by Grace Mikhail. Just missing the sideline there, but impressive angle on her swing.
Great pass from Mikhail. They'll run the middle for Hildebrand. The tip picked up by the Carabin. They go for a pipe attack from Gallardo Haley. Great block by Hildebrand. Left side here. And that will be a kill from Florence Coutier of the Carabin. Off the hands and out from the GG's. And Lionel Woods calls timeout with Montreal leading Ottawa 13-8 in the second set.
Thank you.
Galarno Haley back to serve once again for the Carabin coming off the Gigi's timeout. Gigi's will be forced to give a free ball over. Carabin running a bit of an inside ball there. More trickery coming from the Carabin. They've been really effective running those combination plays. Looked like a 33 set there coming from the Carabin. Interesting play to have a shorter and lower set there going to the left side, but it clearly was effective as they got the kill.
Yeah, I mean, that's the liberty that the Carabin are able to do when they're siding out these free balls very effectively, giving their setter the opportunity to do pretty well whatever she wants on the court here.
Yeah, they're getting creative, and it's clearly paying off as they open up a 15-8 lead. Bristow checks back in for McHale here. Woods looking to take a mini timeout here with the substitution, hopefully force a miss on the serve. And if not, Bristow provided a huge spark for the G's last week. A couple massive kills. Hopefully she can provide that once again.
Yeah, absolutely. She was an offensive weapon for the G's, and hopefully this exchange here will allow her to get into this game and provide the same.
First swing of the game there, or for the set from Bristow, gets blocked, and that will be point Carabin once again. Interesting that they've dropped back Avery Hughes once again to pass, though, of course, as we mentioned, she did play left side last year, and passing combination now of Hughes, Jones, and Odigi. Hopefully that will provide the passing that the G's need to side out of this rotation. Not on this point, though, as another ace from Galarno Haley off the hands of Jones, and that will be 17-8 in favor of Montreal.
Yeah, that was an absolutely beautiful serve there by Chloe Galarno Haley. That ball just dying as soon as it crossed over the tape. Really tough to predict the path.
And now Bristow will drop back to pass. Tight ball from Jones. And that will be point for the Carabin on the net touch by Langevin as she went up to try to set that tight ball. G's look a little deflated at the moment. Difficult with the long serving run. And right on cue, Lionel Woods decides to call timeout. Hopefully he can rejuvenate his team to bring some momentum back to this GG's squad. Galarno Haley back to serve once again for the Carabin. This will be her eighth consecutive serve now, as Montreal leads Ottawa 18-8 here in the second set at Montpetit Hall. Good pass from Odigi. Run the middle to Hildebrand. Dug up by the Carabin. They'll go left side. And there's a huge block from the G's. The combination of Langevin and Hildebrand gets it done on the block. And they will take back the serve, as McHale goes back to serve now with the G's down 18-9.
Well, good timeout by Coach Lionel Woods. Obviously, Galarno Haley took a bit off her serve there, and G's were able to get a perfect pass, run the middle, and then set up a solid block. But missed serve right after is not exactly what you want to see here.
Yeah, it's a real momentum killer. Unfortunate serve there, as that will give the ball back to the Carabin. Georgievich on serve here for the Carabin. Left side ball goes out to Odigi for the GGs, and that will be a kill for Audrey. Odigi goes off the block and out as the G's get into double figures with Hildebrand going back to serve now.
Good high swing there by Odigi, just ripping as hard as she could off hands. She knew the double block was present there and just overpowering the block so the defenders couldn't get it.
Yeah, it's especially effective to do that when you got a setter in the front row. Pipe attack here from the Carabin, and that will go into the net. Point GG's. bit of a scramble miscommunication there between the setter and Yalarno Haley. She's been very consistent all afternoon. An uncharacteristic mistake from her there.
Yep.
Hildebrand back to serve once again for the G's. Great pass from the Carabin. They're running a slide play with the middle and a great kill there from Kaiser Tourigny. Looks the Carabin have run just about every play in their book today.
Yeah, keeping their options open here, and they've Absolutely. Been clicking on every single set that they've been putting out from this new tactic. So first big slide run here, and that went straight to the ground.
Yeah, and they've been passing incredibly well, giving the setter every single option she could want. And they've been taking full advantage. Right side attack now. Well dug by the G's, but they'll call that Ottawa was on the net. That will be point Carabin.
Trying to get a little aggressive here, knowing that we're struggling on the defensive end right now, reaching way over the net and just clipping on it on the way down.
Yeah, it's important to still stay patient even despite the score. Odigi with a big serve, with a big kill there, big swing off the left side. That will fall on the side of the Carabin. As Kachanchich now checks in for the G's, taking out Max Najvain. Kachanchich was a serving sub a few times in the game last week against the Université de Québec at Montréal. Went on a couple of nice runs for the G's. Hopefully she can do the same thing here today.
Yeah, she's been providing a stable option from the baseline, and obviously taking out Langevin as a secondary setter, she can maybe change the pace of the offense a bit as well.
Huge swing there by Alain Desmet. Swing from the left side with the setter in one, and a huge kill for her once again as Montréal leads 22-12. Aside from a few big blocks, she has been virtually unstoppable this afternoon. Tight pass there for Mikhail. Kachanchich picks it up, but the G's are unable to get the ball back over the net. That will be point Carabin.
Mindset here for the G's just got to be to get a few big points here to start the third set with some good momentum here. They're clearly out of this one, but hopefully they can carry over some good skills to the next play.
Great pass of Mikhail, and a great swing by Odigi. Goes off hands and out. Smart play to read the big double block and go off the side of the left side's arms.
Yeah, just some good composed volleyball there, and that's what they need to do to close out this set effectively and bring in some good vibes for the next.
Absolutely, can't be trying to do too much. Good serve by Odigi, tight pass. McKay with the swing over, but a great pancake by the Carabin's lib. Overpass there by Hughes, and a putback by the Carabin in the middle from Kaiser Tourigny, and that will give the Carabin set point here, up 24-13. Unfortunate play there from the G's, not being able to put away on first ball and then an overpass.
Yeah, that's the importance of your side-out game. Really got to put that first ball away and not give the other chance the opportunity to score on you.
Great pass by Jones. Middle attack from McKay, dug up. Galarno Haley will give a free ball back over. Kachanchich goes to the left side for Mikhail. And that falls in on the sideline. Great swing to turn the hips and shoulders for Mikhail there to swing down the line and gets the kill.
Yeah, good first pass by Jones, and then following that up with a solid dig that gives the Kachanchich the option of finding another great option, and Mikhail makes no mistake in squeaking that by down the line.
McKay now on serve for the G's. Great pass by the Carabin. They'll run the middle. Good up by Odigi. Kachanchich goes to the left side for Mikhail once again, who throws it deep into the backcourt. Right side attack now from Desmet. Great dig by the G's as the ball goes back over to the Carabin's side. Another right side attack from the Carabin. Great cut there by Desmet. Off the hands of Hughes and out. What a tight angle she was able to find there as she puts the set away. Final score in the second set is 25-14 in favor of Montreal as they lead the G's 2-0. Welcome back inside Montpetit Hall for the third set of some women's volleyball action between the Montreal Carabins and the Ottawa GGs. Montreal has a 2-0 lead, but the G's will look to turn that around and keep their hopes alive in this game in this third set. Looks like no lineup changes for either team on either side here.
No, it looks like Montreal's trying to run away with this with the same rotation. GG's trying to grind it out for this third set here and hope that they click a bit better.
Interesting decision by the Carabins there to have Gallarneau Haley serve first. Typically, teams that start with serve choose to have their setter in one. Although, given that the Carabins wanted such a long run in the last set with Gallarneau Haley serving, they may be looking to repeat that success.
I think they're also trying to match up with the GG's rotation. We've noticed in the first two sets, the GG's doing just that as well, leaving Max Langevin, the setter for the G's, to be the secondary setter on this team, secondary server on this team. And I think Carabins just trying to match up a regular rotation here with them.
Setter dump over by Langevin, her first of the game. Great pancake dig by the Carabins, but the free ball does sail wide. Carabin Libero telling the team to calm down on some of those balls, but it will ultimately be point GG's as Hildebrand goes back to serve.
Yeah, a little bit of ugly volleyball there. Ref letting some play go through, but you know that'll happen time to time as long as the calls are going both ways.
Yeah, absolutely. Great serve by Hildebrand there, forcing an out-of-system ball. Out-of-system swing from Cloutier is a good one. Middle attack there from McKay is blocked by the Carabins' Kaiser Tourigny. And that will be point Carabins. A little bit of trouble once again today with the GGs on connecting on their middle attacks.
Yeah, they started the game a bit better, getting a few kills in from Janae McKay. They just haven't been able to click as efficiently since then.
Great pass by McHale. And there's a kill from McKay right on schedule. Manages to force it through a big block from the Carabins and tie this set up at 2-2.
Sometimes I think, Eric, you know, they're listening to us on the bench and they just
must be.
They're running what we say. They need to be running more.
Left side attack from the Carabins. A little bit of miscommunication there between Desmet and Cloutier. Looks like Cloutier didn't realize that ball was going to the back row. Tried to take it away from Desmet, and awkward play there as the ball falls into the net. Langevin back to serve once again for the G's. Another great serve from Maxime. And a huge block there from the G's. The combination of McKay and Hughes manages to stuff the left side of the Carabins, and they will take another point for their side. Ottawa up 4-2. Bullet of a serve there from Langevin, very flat. Desmet with a huge rip out of the back row. They've been running almost what looks like an A ball with the the left side back row.
Interesting decision, especially like on a broken play where you typically want to prefer to get the ball tighter to the net, give your hitter more options, but Desmet has made practically zero mistakes today offensively, so they've been able to rely on it from the back row anyways.
Yeah, absolutely. There's an ace from Carabins setter Sarah McLaughlin. Bullet of a serve there in between Jones and McHale. G's will look to side out here. It's been a constant theme all afternoon. Free ball given over by the G's courtesy of Michaela Jones. Middle attack from the Carabins, and there's a huge kill from Georgievic. Right into position number one there, virtually unblocked. Yeah. Very, very quick transition offense there from the Carabins.
Yeah, and that's a big swing. Lots of force behind that ball, finding open court. Nothing
Absolutely.
Much you could do from the GG side of things.
Tons of elevation there. Tough for any middle to get around and block that, especially when she turns it back towards one. Great pass there by McHale off a difficult serve. Odigi with a right side ball goes high up into the air, avoids the ceiling. Great pass there by the libero. And then a bigger swing from Desmet coming out of the right side. Cuts it all the way across the court. Beautiful play there from the Carabins.
Yeah, Carabins have a lot of ball control right now, and on tough situations like that ball floating through the rafters, the libero is still able to deliver a perfect pass, liberating their setter from all three options and finding their key hitter right here, Desmet.
Serve goes long courtesy of the Carabins setter, Sarah McLaughlin. That will be point G's. DG is back to serve for the G's, though it looks like the umpires have some matters to discuss at the net. Perhaps a rotation check for the Carabins. Happens occasionally where the back row left side ends up in front of the front row left side, and of course that would put them out of rotation, but the referees seem to think that everything is okay as ODG goes back to serve. Overpass there from the Carabins, dumped by McKay but dug back up. Good dig by ODG off the right side ball from the Carabins. McHale with the left side swing, goes off the block and out. Great kill from Grace McHale.
Yep, smart swing by Grace McHale there, seeing the double block and turning her swing towards the line the last second to tag the outside arm of the blocker.
Another great serve by ODG, forcing McLaughlin to go on the run. Now a roll shot over by Desmet. Langevin with a dump, looked like from the attack line, managed to get blocked by Georgievich.
Yeah, not sure what the run was there, if that was supposed to be a dump on two from behind the baseline, or they were trying to squeak McKay in there for a quick transition middle run, but ultimately didn't work for the G's there.
Heads up blocking by the Carabins in any case. Although the serve from the Carabins goes long, and that will give the ball right back to the GGs in a tie game here in this third set, 7-7.
GGs getting bailed out by the missed serves from the Carabins here. They got to use this as momentum and build their points here from the service lane, where they've done a good job in the first set of applying pressure.
Serve down the line from McKay. They go right side to Desmet to the Carabins. Great dig by ODG off a scramble play. Hughes on the right side, and there's another kill for Avery Hughes. Great set there by Langevin, reversing the flow off a nice dig from ODG, and that will be point GG's. They go up 8-7.
Yeah, spectacular dig there by ODG, just getting an arm under that ball in the middle of the court. Still went nice and high, and allowing the secondary setting options to do what they need to do.
Absolutely. Always difficult to get those balls up, especially off the net. This time, though, Desmet goes down the line, past the shoulder of McKay, the middle. Great swing there by Desmet, managing to turn her shoulders and avoid the block. The middle, Georgievich, now back to serve for the Carabins. Rocket of a serve falls just long. Another missed serve there by the Carabins, and the GGs need to take advantage of some of these if they want to keep their hopes alive in this match.
Exactly. That's three in a row here for the Carabins, and they've been serving really aggressively. They're going for it on the baseline, but the GGs getting lucky with those balls sailing a bit out.
Hughes with a good serve. Carabins go left side to Gallarino. Haley, great dig by ODG, and a block off the overpass by the G's. They go right side on a C ball to Hughes. And there's another kill from Avery Hughes, this time from the back row. Some great defense by the GGs pays off as they get a massive kill and open up a two-point lead.
Great court awareness there by the rookie middle, Hildebrand from the G's, noticing that that ball from ODG that was dug was going over to the Carabins side, quickly turns around to try and get a touch on the block, effectively getting a nice slowdown that allowed the GGs to run their offense as usual.
Left side, Maud Babin checks in for the Carabins, taking out Florence Cloutier. And the first serve goes right to her, and that's an ace from Avery Hughes. Difficult float serve as always, a lot of movement on that, and it falls just short in front of the Carabins defense. And now Carabins head coach Olivier Trudel wants to talk things over with his team. Montréal calls timeout with the GGs leading 11-8. Into a lot of trouble on serve receive. Hughes to serve once again for the Gigi's coming out of the timeout. Good float serve, forcing a down ball roll shot over from the Carabin. Puts the Gigi's in a little bit of trouble though. McHale with the left side attack, and there's a kill from Grace McHale off the hands of Carabin libero Brittany McLaughlin and out. Some great scramble plays by the Gigi's there.
Yep, they're doing a great job of at least picking up the ball to get a set off, but got to give credit here to Avery Hughes attacking the newly substituted left side that draws out of the passing rotation here now for the Carabin.
Yeah, Alain Desmet, the right side, will go back and pass for the Carabin. Great pass there by the middle, by the libero McLaughlin, and that will lead to a kill in the middle from the Carabin as they will take possession back.
Gigi's got to do their best here of avoiding putting any ball on Brittany McLaughlin. She's done a great job giving in-system balls to her setter, which just so happens to be her sister.
Good pass there by McHale off the serve from Desmet. Picked up by McLaughlin. Good pass there from Jones. Hit the middle run from Hildebrand. There's a kill for the rookie middle. Nicole Hildebrand with a great kill off the hands and out. And that will give the Gigi's a 13-9 lead.
She's a high flyer in this team, and you got to give her the ball nice and high so she can bring that down. And Max Angevin missed the first cue there and trusting her abilities and going right back to her and making no mistakes scoring on that second opportunity.
Absolutely. She's got one of the best verts on the team, and out of the middle, that is especially dangerous. But a setter dump there from setter McLaughlin. And that will be Point Carabin. Gigi's struggled to pick some of those up. She's been putting them into very, very creative spots in the pot. Serve from Gallardo Haley. Puts the G's in a tough spot as they go out of system. Hughes with the pipe attack out of the back row. Well picked up by the Carabin. They run middle, and there's another kill from Kaiser Tourigny out of the middle. Another big swing from the Carabin leads to a point, as the G's lead gets cut down to 13-11 here in the third set.
Gigi's in a tough position blocking-wise, knowing very well that their wing options on the Carabin side have been kind of dominating this game, forced to give them the respect on the fast sets from the Carabin setter, but the middle runs have just been so effective on the Carabin side as well.
Great rally here. Lots of great swings and pickups on both sides, but the slide attack from Kaiser Tourigny out of the middle will be another point for the Carabin. More trickery from setter McLaughlin off some very, very good passing from her sister. Another serve from Gallardo Haley. Great pass by Great McHale. They run the middle through Hildebrand. Carabin with a tip from the left side. G's managed to pick it up. McHale will give a free ball back over. Left side attack from the Carabin, and there's another kill from the Carabin. This time it's number 7, the left side, newly substituted Maud Babin. And that will tie the game at 13-13. McHale asking for a towel on the court, looks a little slippery. Head coach Lionel Woods taking advantage of this quick break to talk things over with his rookie left side Odigi. G's have to get out of this rotation quickly, though. Gallardo Haley has been putting them in tremendously difficult positions with her serve so far. Good pass from McHale. Left side attack from Odigi. Looking for hands, but it will go just wide down the line. And that will be Point Carabin as they take a lead 14-13. Their first lead in the set since it was about 4-3. G's got to look to side out soon.
Yeah, the Gigi's are always in a tough position with Gallardo Haley at the baseline. She's been ripping serves, but here we go. We'll take credit for that point here, folks.
Commentator's curse in effect once again.
Gigi's even up the game here, 14 apiece, with number 14 back to serve, Nicole Hildebrand.
Hildebrand serve floats just long through the baseline. That will be Point Carabin. No libero in on this point for the Carabin, though, as Kaiser Tourigny, the middle, goes back to serve, and libero Brittany McLaughlin substitutes off. Good serve there from Kaiser Tourigny. Huge swing from Odigi, but a great dig by the middle. And then the right side attack in the back row, a C ball from Desmet, manages to score off the hands of left side Grace McHale out. And now Lionel Woods calls timeout with Montreal coming all the way back to take a 16-14 lead here in the third set. Kaiser Tourigny, the middle, back again to serve once again for the Carabin, coming out of the timeout. Langevin with a bit of a run there, sets out of system to ODG. Great dig there by Gaetan Nohaily. Tip from Babin. ODG with the swing once again off the block and back onto the GG's side. The left side attack by the Carabin blocked once again. They'll go back to her, this time blocked once again. And the final attack, Desmet puts it into the net. That will be point Gigi's. Huge momentum point there for the G's. Some great defense, great blocking. Fought some adversity there. It looked like that one of those left side swings didn't touch the block, but ref gave them anyway. Some good fight there by the G's to get back into the set as Kachanchich subs in for Langevin to serve in the back row. Great float serve by Kachanchich, putting the Carabin in trouble. Left side attack from Babin gets blocked. Out of system set by McGlashan, gets blocked once again. Roll shot over from the Carabin. Kachanchich goes to the left side for ODG. She tips and scores down the line. Called in by the lines person. And that will tie the third set up at 16 points apiece. Great smart play there by ODG, recognizing the big block and just tipping around it.
Yeah, and that whole point there is possible by the effective blocking from the GG's. Crowd's bumping here. We got a block party going on.
Great serve by Kachanchich. Out of system attack by the Carabin. Decent pass there by Kachanchich, tight to the net, but unfortunately no one able to scoop it up. That will be point Carabin as they go up 17-16. Difficult play there, especially when you have the setter taking the first ball and the libero nowhere near to take second ball.
Yeah, libero got to be patient to try and see where that ball trajectory is going to go. Obviously difficult when the ball lands tight.
Another missed serve there from the Carabin. It's been the tail of the tape for this set. Gigi's just looking to take advantage now because Carabin have been putting them in very difficult positions on serve receive.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's a big break there because McGlashan's been putting tough serves in on the Gigi's side.
ODG with a great serve. Out of system set. Pipe attack here from the GG's ODG, and that goes just long, looking for hands. Could not find any, and that will be point Montreal.
Yeah, tough break there for the GG's. Probably got to try and find a better option there in system. Open up the wings a bit more, and the court's a little easier to see with the distance of the front row ball.
Especially with the Carabin scrambling a little bit, it would have been very difficult to get a double block on that ball.
Exactly.
But now a swing from McKay, called out by the lines person in the back row. Great connection there between Kachanchich and McKay, but the ball sails just long out the back. Montreal up 19-17. Gigi's fighting to stay in the set and in the match. Good pass by McHale. She'll get it back and get her chance to swing. Overpass there by the Carabin, a big scramble play. Right side attack now from Hughes. Picked up by McGlashan. The middle set to Georgievich gets blocked once again. They go left side to Gallarneau Haley, and she manages to score on the left side off the hands of Hughes and out the side. Great patience there by Sutter McGlashan to mix up all her options and find a way for the Caravan to score as they take a three-point lead.
Yeah, it was a great rally from both sides there. Lots of great defense, big swings, big blocks. Good volleyball.
Good pass from Mikhail. Hughes with a tip to take Desmet out of the play. They'll go left side to Gallarneau Haley. Great dig there by Mikhail. G's forced to give a free ball over, but great to even keep that ball off the ground at all. And a huge block there by the GGs. Avery Hughes and Janae McKay combined to stuff Gallarneau Haley. Massive, massive block there by the G's as they managed to hopefully get some momentum back on their side and turn the tide in this third set.
Yeah, huge point there. You can feel the energy from the GG's side now. Hopefully they can carry through, close this gap, and close this set as well.
McKay with the serve. Good pass from McGlashan. The right side swing from Desmet. Huge cut across there. Great find there by the right side. And she will score. That gives Montreal their lead back up to 3 points.
Yeah, that was a tough rotation for the GGs to capitalize on as the Carabins both had Desmet and Gallarneau Haley on both wings in their respective positions there. They had to respect both offensive weapons and couldn't get two blocks on either side.
Good pass by ODG. The middle attack from Hildebrand blocked, but the G's managed to send a free ball back over. Great defense there by Jones. Middle attack off the hands of ODG and will fall long on the side of the G's. That will be a point for the Carabins as they go up 22-18. Timeout called by head coach Lionel Woods of U Ottawa. Up there by Jones of the GGs. Right side attack from Hughes. Will sail just long. Point Carabin. Great serve there from number 18, Virginie Angelini. Putting the G's in a tough spot once again.
Yeah, they're just trying to corral any points here they can. Seems to be a little deflated on the GGs side, but hopefully they can carry a few big points here. There you go.
Just like that. Great swing from Mikhail. Finds a hole, finds some points. And the G's will look to use that in their momentum for a comeback as Najvani checks back in for Kaczyancic.
G's in a good position here. Avery Hughes, a reliable serving threat from the baseline, always putting nice serves in. And last time she did a great job targeting the newly subbed in left side for the Carabins.
It's a good thing I knocked on wood after you said that, because Hughes did manage to put her serve in. G's with a pancake as Mikhail puts it back over. Left side out of system attack from Gallarneau Haley. Mikhail with another swing, and this one will fall long. G's asking for a touch off the block. Woods looks furious, but the G's will not get the call. That will be point for the Carabins, and they will open up match point here with a 24-19 lead.
Double substitution here coming in for the Carabins, bringing in their secondary setter to serve and a bigger blocking option on the front row.
at this point, G's fighting for their lives in this match. Every point could be the end. So look to see some big attacks from the G's as they got nothing to lose. Just like that, great kill from Hildebrand in the middle. Great pass by the G's. Great find by Langevin to get Hildebrand up high above the block as she managed to go off the hands of Kaiser Tourigny and out. Mikhail now steps back to serve for the G's. Good serve by Mikhail. Carabin give a free ball over. A lot of spin on that ball. And Langevin with the setter dump. Her second kill of the match on the setter dump. Great play there by Langevin as the G's look to slowly be fighting their way back into this one.
Yeah. Maximum effort there by Maxime Langevin, getting nice and high and throwing that ball down.
And you never know. Left side attack now from the Carabin. Good dig by Hughes. Left side attack from Odigi. And there's another kill from the rookie left side. Great swing by Odigi to keep this match going. It's now 24-22 for Montreal. As head coach Olivier Trudel wants to put his starters back in for the Carabin as McGlashan and Desmet check back in for Montreal.
Gigi's playing with a great sense of urgency here, knowing their life is on the line here with any mistake and doing a great job of keeping that pressure on and playing mistake-free volleyball.
Serve from Mikhail. Puts the Carabin in a difficult spot. Left side attack from Gallarno. Haley goes off the block and out. That will do it for this match. Another great effort by the GGs there.
Tough to play a strong team. The Carabin proving a 5-1 here, and GGs falling 2-3 on the regular season. Thank you for joining us for this broadcast of GGs Volleyball. I'm Dan Proto, joined here by Eric Dissinayake. Thank you, and have a great afternoon, everyone.